In this video demonstration, we will show you how easy it is to work with DITA documents in the author visual editing mode and present some of Oxygen's unique and useful DITA editing features. The visual DITA editor in Oxygen allows users with limited knowledge of XML to edit DITA documents in a manner that is similar to working with a regular word processing application. To demonstrate this, our use case requires that we add a new topic to an existing DITA documentation project of a mobile phone product. We'll use the author visual editing mode to create a new topic, edit it, and publish it in PDF and web help responsive formats. Our documentation project is organized in a DITA map that is currently opened in the DITA Maps Manager view. We'll add our topic at the end of the first chapter. The goal of the topic is to present general information about a phone model, so we'll name it General Presentation. A whole set of DITA-specific actions are automatically added on the toolbar when the DITA file is opened in author mode. For example, there are actions for altering text appearance or for managing tables and lists. At the beginning of the topic, we need a section to list a series of the most common phone buttons. We'll delete the empty paragraph element, then we insert a new section. The newly added section displays two empty placeholders for a section title and the first paragraph. Now we need a table to present the button names and descriptions. We do not want to have a title for our table. Now we set the number of rows and columns and the fixed column layout. We do not want any cell borders, so we set the row and column separators to 0. The first two columns contain the button icon and name, so we can just join the first two table header cells. The last column describes the button's function. Now, we insert an image representing the button's icon. Now we insert the button name and apply an italic styling. The last column is probably not wide enough to accommodate the content, so we adjust it a bit. Since the button may perform multiple functions, we'll use an unordered list. For the second function, we'll insert a new list item. Similarly, we'll add other button descriptions. We just realized that we need an extra row, so we click the Insert Row button, then add the description of another button. We are not happy with the column widths, so we'll adjust them by simply dragging the column borders. Also, we want to change the row's order. To do this, select the entire row, then drag it to its new position. In the next section, we want to include some basic technical specifications. We already have the content written in an HTML page, so we'll copy it from there and paste it in our topic. Notice that the Oxygen Smart Paste capability preserves the content styling. Moving on, we'll add a new section that presents the phone's available colors. We already have a description of the available colors written in another topic, so we'll use DITA conref mechanism to reuse content from that topic. The referenced content is displayed with a darker background to indicate that it is not editable in this context. The link takes you to the document where the content is stored. At the end of the topic, we want to add a link to the phone's website. We just use the web link action to insert the link. Now we'll add an image that shows the phone's color choices. This time, we'll just drag the image from a file browser and drop it into our document. Now we want to publish the document in PDF format. Oxygen XML comes with ready-to-use transformation scenarios, and with just a few clicks, we can obtain a published output. The generated PDF file has a table of contents with bookmarks to all the chapters and sections. And here is our general presentation topic that we have just edited. At the end of the demonstration, we also want to publish our documentation project into a web help responsive format. Again, we invoke the Configure Transformation Scenario action in the DITA Maps Manager view and choose the web help responsive transformation. We'll use one of the predefined skins. And this is how the web help responsive output looks like. And this concludes our demonstration. Thanks for watching.